Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Vaporwave is a microgenre of electronic music and its visual counterpart that emerged in the early 2010s. The visual aesthetic, often styled as aesthetics with full-width uppercase characters, is a mashup of early internet imagery, late 1990s web design, glitch art, cyberpunk tropes, Japanese anime, Greco-Roman statues, and 3D rendered objects.
Open 24 hours.
I created this one and will show you how to recreate it. I provided this image of NTSC video color bars that you could use for the background. Its link is in my video's description below or in my project files. I also included this image of the ancient Greek statue Venus de Milo. We'll also incorporate a generic image that connotes the visual equivalency of elevator music. I didn't provide this particular image because it's licensed by Shutterstock. However, there are many from which to choose on the web. As long as you incorporate the subjects that I mentioned in the intro, your finished Vaporwave image is limited only by your imagination. Because Vaporwave images have a satirical or mocking view of cutting-edge graphics, they live and flourish in a low-tech world of visual imagery. All this to say, there's no right or wrong, just have fun creating it. First, we'll create a simple low-tech grid and place it in perspective. This type of grid is a common theme seen in Vaporwave images. Notice that the thickness of the grid remains consistent throughout. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with white, but before we do, check your foreground and background colors. If they're not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is our background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Go to Filter and Vanishing Point. Adobe added this feature starting in CS2. Click the Zoom Tool icon and Alt-click or Option-click 3 times to zoom out this much. Click the Create Plane tool and place it just outside the left side, halfway between the top and bottom. Click and release your cursor and place your tool just outside the right side of your image. Position it near the edge of the right edge of your canvas, just below the bottom of the white background. Position your cursor near the left edge of your canvas. If you see red or yellow lines, move the tool until they become blue. Open the Zoom tool again and click on your image twice. We'll take a screenshot of it. To do this on Windows, press the Print Screen key located at the top row of your keyboard. On a Mac, press Shift Command 5 and pause this video to follow these instructions. Once you have a screenshot, click OK. Press Ctrl or Command V to paste the screenshot onto your document. We'll enlarge the screenshot by pressing Ctrl or Command T to open our Transform tool. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. To reposition it, go inside the Transform's bounding box and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. We'll merge the two top layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Change its blend mode to Divide. We'll increase its visibility by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Let's group the grid images into a folder to save space in the Layers panel. Shift-click the bottom grid layer to make all of the grid layers active and press Ctrl or Command G. Name the folder Grid. Open the statue I provided. We'll separate the statue from the background by making a selection around the statue. To do this, open your Quick Selection tool and make its tolerance anywhere from 10 to 20 pixels. Drag your tool over the statue to select it. To remove unwanted selections outside the statue, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over them. To check it, press Q on your keyboard. Revert it back into a selection by pressing Q again. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy it onto its own layer. To place the statue onto the video color bars, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the color bars. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize and position it, open your Transform tool and drag the width or the height to the right until it's approximately this size. Then drag it down until you can see the head. If you want to rotate the head, go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, drag it clockwise. Continue to finesse its size and position, then press Enter or Return. We'll convert the statue into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Under Advanced Blending, you'll see that the red, green, and blue channels are checked. Uncheck the red channel and click OK. Make a copy of the layer and double-click this Advanced Blending icon to open it in the Layer Style window. Check the red channel to make it visible again and uncheck the green channel. At this point, your statue will look normal. Press and hold the Shift key as you press the right arrow key 4 times. This moves the statue copy to the right 40 pixels. We'll group the statue layers into a folder by shift-clicking the bottom statue and pressing Ctrl or Command G. Name it Statue. Open your Horizontal Type tool and pick a font. We'll adjust its size after we type the text. The aliasing is sharp and center alignment. Type out your text and highlight it. Drag the size icon to the left or right to adjust its size. Open your Move tool and drag it to approximately here. You can always reposition it later if you want. Convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Make a copy of it and hide the original. Double-click an empty area of the copy to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the Color box. Pick a color for your text. Since I already know the color I want, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field 5, 8, F, F, D, 8. Then click OK on both windows. Open your Transform tool and click the Warp Transform icon. Open the custom warp list. I'll click Bulge, but feel free to experiment with the others. For the bend, I'll type in -5. Then click the check mark at the top. Make the original text layer visible and active. Go to Filter, Distort, and Wave. This filter will create an interesting wave distortion behind your text. Before we adjust the settings, feel free to experiment with them. For mine, I'll type in 40 for the number of generators. For the wavelength, I'll type in 1 and 29. And for the amplitude, it'll be 1 and 25. The horizontal and vertical scales are both 100%, the type is sine, and repeat edge pixels. Double-click an empty area of the text layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the Color box. Pick a color for your text's wave distortion. I'll type in F, F, 0, 8, F, C. Shift-click the top layer to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command G to group them into a folder. I'll name it Text. If you want to adjust the size of your text with its wave distortion behind it, open your Transform tool. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the smart filters will be temporarily turned off while we use the Transform tool. Just click OK. Then adjust its size and position. We'll type in Japanese, since Japanese words and images are a common theme in Vaporwave graphics. I recommend using Google's translation webpage to do this. Open your browser and type in translate.google.com. Click this arrow to open the list of languages and click on your native language. In this empty area, type in a word or words that you'd like to appear on your final image. Click this arrow and click Japanese. Highlight the word and press Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Minimize your browser and make a new layer. Press T on your keyboard to open back your type tool, click on your document, and press Ctrl or Command V to paste the Japanese text onto it. To enlarge it, highlight the text and drag the size icon to the right. Position it to an empty area you like. Remember, you can always adjust the size and position of any of the elements on your Vaporwave image. Open your generic idealized landscape or another image of your choice and drag it onto the tab of your Vaporwave image. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Open your transform tool and adjust its size and position to your liking. Double-click the layer to open its layer style window and uncheck the channel that has the best effect for your image.
Aesthetics.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.